Thank you. your presence here symbolizes your love for them, and they feel blessed to be supported by so many family and friends. The love felt in this place, though, flows first from the heart of God. He teaches us that love is not an emotion, but a choice. Margie, Kate, and Adam are here because they chose to love each other for the rest of their lives. One of the oldest stories in the Bible begins with this example of the commitment of marital love. Thus, from the book of Ruth, I read, "Ask me not to leave you or to return from following you, for where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God." The greatest love story ever told begins with the word, "For God so loved the world." The deepest love known to man is the love of God. We love because He first loved us. Who presents this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Margie, Kate, and Adam, if you are willing to receive each other as life's partners in accordance with God's will, I command you now to join right hands. In all of life, rare is a moment that is filled with as much hope and joy as this sacred moment. Now that you have joined hands as a token of your love, you should be mindful that the vows that you are about to take before Almighty God are vows that come from His heart. He instituted marriage. He blessed it. And He requires that your vows be kept sacred and made real through everyday living. These vows will be locked in your memories as a reminder of your lifelong pledge to love the one who stands willingly and expectantly before you. The memory of this moment is intended to strengthen your marriage through the years and to cause you to give thanks to God for one another. The Word of God encourages married couples to submit themselves to one another out of respect for God. Thus, both of you should be willing to set aside your own needs, wants, and interests for the good of the other. Each of you must do this to demonstrate servanthood in marriage. A Christian husband will never have a problem leading his family if he assures them that he will set aside his own needs and desires for the best interest of them in order to help each reach their full potential. Adam, I charge you this day in the fashion of Christ to take the initiative to love your wife. There is not a marriage problem that any couple faces that cannot be helped by a man learning how to more fully and adequately love his wife in the pattern of Christ and in the power of the Holy Spirit. She feels more secure and protected if she knows that you love her. The Scripture declares you should never take her for granted, but love her as you love yourself. You are to nourish, provide, cherish, and protect, and grant her security from the world, as well as a climate for growth in which she can reach her highest potential for the glory of God. I charge you both to be an example before God in showing the world what He had in mind when He conceived of the home. Be a source of encouragement for others that contemplate marriage in their future, and help silence the critics of marriage by the witness of your happiness. Allow your home to illustrate the truth of Christ's relationship to His church, and let the Lord rejoice in your obedience. So now, Margie, Kate, and Adam, if you're willing to commit yourself to one another in accordance to God's plan, facing one another, you will repeat your vows after me. I, Adam, take you, Margie, Kate.
I, Adam, take you, Margie, Kate.
To be my wedded wife.
Be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
Have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As the head of our household.
as the head of our household.
I promise to be obedient to God's will for our lives.
I promise to be obedient to God's will for our lives.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Honor you.
Honor you.
Protect you.
Protect you.
And forgive you.
And forgive you.
As Christ has forgiven me.
As Christ has forgiven me.
I will cleave only and forever to you.
I will cleave only and forever to you.
As my love and my best friend.
As my love and my best friend.
Until death divides us.
Until death divides us.
We are one heart.
We are one heart.
I am Margie Kate. Take you, Adam.
I'm Margie Kate. Take you, Adam.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poor.
For richer or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I promise to follow you.
I promise to follow you.
As my spiritual leader.
As my spiritual leader.
In full support of the endeavors God puts before us.
In full support of the endeavors God puts before us.
I will love you.
I will love you.
Pray for you.
Pray for you.
Encourage you.
Encourage you.
And forgive you.
And forgive you.
As Christ has forgiven me.
As Christ has forgiven me.
I will cleave only and forever to you.
I will cleave only and forever to you.
As my love and best friend.
As my love and best friend.
Until death divides us.
Until death divides us.
We are one heart.
We are one heart.
May I have the rings, please? Since time immemorial, the ring has been used to seal important commitments. The purity of the metal speaks of the purity of your love for each other. The perfect circle symbolizes the eternity of your love, having no beginning and no end. The value of the ring should represent the great value of this marriage in both of your hearts. Except for your relationship with God, nothing in life should be more important than the maintenance of your marriage. Adam, would you take this ring, place it upon her finger, and repeat after me. With this ring,
this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Margie Kate, would you take this ring and place it upon Adam's finger? Adam, it's been Margie Kate's desire that you have a ring, and as you wear it before men, it proclaimed to the world that you belong to her and she belongs to you, and you both belong to God. In addition, she had these words engraved on the inside. All my love forever. As you wear this ring, it proclaims to you her abiding love. Margie Kate, would you repeat after me? With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
1 Corinthians tells us that a faith, hope, and love, the greatest of these is love. This love is slow to lose patience. It looks for a way of being constructive. It's not possessive. It is neither anxious to impress, nor does it cherish inflated ideas of its own importance. This love has good manners. It does not pursue selfish advantage. It is not irritable. It is glad when truth prevails. This kind of love knows no limit to its endurance, no end to its trust, no fading of its hope. It can outlast anything. This kind of love will stand when all else has fallen. So may your love be. As a symbol of this unity, you will mix sands. The colors of these sands are symbolic. The white that I have already poured represents a spiritual foundation. The blue represents Margie Kate and her family and traditions that bring her to this moment. The orange represents Adam and his family and the history and heritage that brings him to this moment. The grains of sand celebrate union and serve as a potent symbol of how your love is forever joined, affirming your new unified relationship as a couple. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated again, so will your marriage be a molding of two individual personalities being bonded together, forming one heart and one love. having pledged your love and loyalty to each other, having sealed that pledge with the sharing of the rings, by the authority of God and the laws of this state, I pronounce you are husband and wife. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Adam Henry Miller. Margie Kate and Adam would like to thank you for being here for this happy occasion. You're invited to a reception that's being held to my left, to your right, in the tents that you see. Please begin to enjoy the food. Margie Kate and Adam will join you momentarily. You are dismissed.
Right. show up every evening. Man and the moon comes out to play. It's just that way. Today
daddy, but if you don't mind, I'm only gonna kiss you on the cheek this time. Oh, with all that I've done wrong, I must have done something right to deserve a hug every morning and butterfly kisses. Give it up for him, y'all. Excuse me. Now, this was not part of the plan. The reason why I changed my mind, because she looks so beautiful standing here dancing with her father, and she's such a beautiful bride. So this is, we're going to sing this song. Can you sing? Just a little bit? Just a little. Hear me out, just a little. Yeah, there you go. You'll try. Okay.
So beautiful to me.
Yeah, that's all we need, baby. That's all we need, man. That's what I'm talking about.
You are so beautiful to me.
Hey, this guy can sing.
Can't you see?
We break it down on one knee.
You are so beautiful to me.
I'm gonna put you in the band, man. Yes, is that okay?
Points. Can't you see? You're everything that he hoped for, and you sing from heaven above. Cause you are so beautiful. To me.
Give it up for him, y'all. Show him a round of applause. Yo, Nico, get down. Y'all ready to get this party started? I want everybody on the dance floor. Come on, we're gonna try to get this party started right now. Hey, come on. What you gonna do? Oh, what you gonna do? Do you wanna get? I need everybody on the dance floor. What you gonna do? Come on. Do you wanna get out? Oh, what you do? We didn't come all the way from New York for nothing. Gonna get out. Come on.
Next thing you know, she's like, no, 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 no. Everybody! yourself, walk it by yourself.
I have the rings.
I want one of the girls and one of the guys to have either ring.
Okay, so
the best man and Gabby.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, we're gonna have to do a little maneuver at that point. Let me back up. I just realized I missed something. When we move up here, then I'm going to say to you, if you're willing to receive each other's life partner and according to God's will, would you please join hands? It is at that point I'm going to remind you to hand your flower.
So good.
Oh, he looks real good.
So gentle.
Okay, let's take it.
I can't stand it. I want to see it.
I do too. I want to see what we did.
Oh my goodness, those are so pretty.
Thank you.
I didn't know y'all call them something like that.
I see the little eagle. I wonder what that's for.
These are so pretty.
What do you put them on?
Oh.
Thank
you. Thank you so much.
Ask them.
Thank you.
I only have one daughter. I love her dearly. I just want her to be real happy, and I know she's picked a good guy. And I just want to say, Margie Kate, I love you all in my heart. I'm and I both do.
It's
biggest tears of joy. Okay. I really feel like I'm gaining a son, not losing a daughter. And Margie Kate, I love you so much, and I hope this wedding is everything you've ever wanted. And I know Adam is everything you've ever wanted as a man. Mom, I love you dearly. And here's to my daughter, Margie Kate.
Here, here. Yeah.
Love you, Dad.
Right.
Love you. Now for the easy part. Adam, I tell you, become a good friend. You're going to be more than a son-in-law. You're going to be like a son. I knew Adam was a keeper when he came up that day and said he wanted to help me bush hog. So I tell you, I like that about Adam. And we've become good friends. We've gone on a couple of hunting trips together. Adam still hadn't taught me to shot as good as he can shoot, but he's working on it. And Adam, I just welcome you to our family. Thank you so much for being so good to Margie Kate. And all I ask is you take care of my daughter and that you always be the man to her that she deserves. Here's to Adam. One more thing, just to the couple. Y'all please be good to each other, love each other, be faithful to each other, and everything will go well. Your mother and I had a long relationship together, and always keep God in the center of your marriage, and everything will go fine. Here's to that couple. And if anybody would like the same thing, now's the time.
I love my sister very much, and I could not have picked a better person for her to marry. I think y'all have a lot of similarities, and I know that Adam's a great, great guy, and I know that y'all be very happy together. Love you very much.
You're here.
I just want to say congratulations to y'all, and I'm so happy for you. And Miss Debbie and Mr. Tony and Mr. and Miss Miller, y'all did a great job with them. And Adam, hope you know how lucky you are. Margie Kate is a great girl. And I know I hadn't gotten to know you just like really, really good, but I've been around you a good bit, and I hope we have a lot more time together just because of work and everything. But I do know that Margie Kate, like ever since she was young, she's always dreamed of that fairy tale ending and her Prince Charming. And she had never settled for anything. She knew what she wanted. And she's always looked at her parents and seen what a great relationship they have. And just, you know, the way they are and how much they love each other is so good to me. You know, that's how she wanted me. That's what she wanted. And that right there means the world about me. And just take care of her. And I know you will. I know you know all of this. And the fact that they have taken you in and love you so much and treat you like their son. Margie Kate, you know, I love you, and I'll do anything for you. And I'm good at other people's relationships. Yeah. And I guess if I have any advice, not that you want it from me, but just always, you know, remember how it felt the first time y'all met, and always keep that puppy love, young love feeling alive, and keep God in the middle of it. And when things, you know, there's going to be rough times, and just always go to him and never turn your back on him and each other. And you can make it. And I know Margie Kate's going to give it her all, and I know you are too. So, cheers.
Studied hard, always going forward, putting a foot forward, pushing. Went right on high school and then to nursing school, and she did real well in the school work. Had very good grades all the way through. Always proud of her. She's nice looking, and Adam made a good choice, and I think Margie Kate did too. They're both fine, and we're pleased to have Adam in our family, and we just hope that they'll have a long, happy life. Main thing is put your faith in God, trust Him in all that you do, make Him first, and you'll have a happy life.
Here, here. I've spent a lot of time with Adam over the last 5 or 6 years, and probably a lot more than we wanted to sometimes, but it's been good, and I've got to know Margie Kate a little bit, and I think you made a really good choice, and just proud for y'all. Just, y'all got a lot of decisions to make over the next couple of years, and just remember to keep God first in y'all's marriage, and things will work out good for you.
Well, I know that I didn't get the chance to know Adam very well when, you know, before they got engaged, but the one thing that I've always known is how happy he makes Margie Kate, and a year later, she's happy as ever, and that's all I could want as a friend is for someone to treat her that well and to make her happy and to cherish her, so take care of my friend Adam. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And thank you for allowing Jax to be part of this. For those that don't know, Margie Kate was our flower girl in our wedding. So she holds a special part in our life, as well as I started her when she was 3, riding horses. And so she's always been one of my kids. And it's been good to see you grow up.
Yeah.
And I'm proud of you.
I'm glad that Margie Kate found somebody that makes her happy. And you need to throw me that bouquet tomorrow.
I just wanted to say my time in knowing you guys has been short. Margie Kate and I met in nursing school, and I was introduced to Margie Kate's mom and dad. And you know, I know her as a very non-selfish, always giving, wanting to do for others. And she's the exact replica of her mom and dad. You know, they are just the same way. And Adam seems to have that personality too. You know, just very easygoing, laid back. You know, everybody, let's get along. But I've enjoyed knowing Margie Kate, and her attitude has been a blessing to me. And you know, it's encouraging to have those types of friends. So I appreciate you being so nice, and your mom and dad. Adam, and I know you'll be that way, and y'all just be a happy family together.
Thank you.
Thank y'all again.
Thank you.
See you tomorrow.